I'm Jennifer Smart, and we're here at the Arclight Theater in Hollywood, California, for the highly anticipated opening of The Last Song, starring Miley Cyrus and Greg Kinnear. What is your favorite kind of music to listen with your friends and family?
Well, my brother likes Nirvana, and I listen to that with him, and I also like Lady Gaga.
This movie is about music bringing people together. What is your favorite kind of music to listen to with family and friends?
My favorite kind of music is definitely alternative. I like that Jason Mraz, Jack Johnson. My favorite song right now is Eric Hutchinson's Rock and Roll.
What projects are you working on?
I'm working on a CD. It's coming out. It's entitled Step Back to Reality. It has 9 completely original songs that I perform guitar, drums, and vocals.
This movie is about music bringing people together. What kind of music do you like to listen to with your family and friends?
I love indie rock. I'm a huge indie rock fan.
I like rock and roll music. I like Bruce Springsteen. I like Fleetwood Mac.
I like party and dance music with my family and friends.
I'm not going to lie, I love pop music. Anything on the radio.
Do you have any upcoming tours or anything that we should be looking out for?
Yeah, well, we're on tour right now. It's called the Verizon Experience the Magic Tour, and we just played in Minnesota and Chicago last week, and this weekend we're going to be in Philadelphia and New Jersey. So yeah.
The cool thing about it, Emily Osment's hosting it. So she's, yeah. We're just going from city to city with Emily Osment. It's an adventure. It's a lot of fun.
Tell us a little bit about the story of The Last Song.
It's a story about family. It's a story about family healing. It's a story about first love. It's a story about faith.
This movie is about music bringing families together. What kind of music do you like to listen to with your family and friends?
Oh, wow. What a great question. In our house, we have both Sirius Radio, and a lot of times that has Top 20 on 20. I have very young girls. They love to listen to, pop music. But when I write, I listen to very tranquil spa music that seems to bring out the most creativity in me. But also, if I'm writing a film, what I'll do is I'll come up with songs that I think, if I was to make the film, I would want them to be in the film. And then when I listen to those songs, it kind of gets me into the mode of writing those characters.
This movie is about music bringing family together. What kind of music do you like to listen to with your family and friends?
I actually sing, and I have a song on iTunes, which is really cool, and it's called Fallen. And I listen to my own music, which is... You always have to listen to your own music. But I listen to Miley a lot. I think she's really good, and I'm really excited to see a movie because she looks like an awesome actress, and I've seen every movie she's in.
What kind of music do you like to listen to with your family and friends?
I listen to a lot of 60s rock, classic, music and stuff. Like, I listen to, The Doors and AC/DC and stuff, and just a lot of rock and stuff. But I also, like a lot of chill things, too. I listen to, The Shins and stuff like that. So, my range is kind of endless, really.
Are you anything like Trip on I'm in the Band?
Little bit. I mean, we're both guitar players, and we both love rock and roll and like to have fun and stuff. I think from where we're different, he gets out of any bad situation possible. Like, he knows how to get out of anything. Like, if that was me, I'd be like, I don't know how to get out of this. So, that's kind of how we're different.
This movie is about music bringing family together. What kind of music do you like to listen to with your family and friends?
Oh, my God. Actually, music brings our family together because my brother plays guitar, sings, and writes song, as does my dad. And we, as a family, get together sometimes, and they strum the guitar, and my mom and I sing, and we sing Beatles songs and their original songs, so I completely identify. But our favorite music in mine, I love Led Zeppelin. It's my favorite band. The Beatles, Jimi Hendrix, The Who, and I like classical music.
Can you give us any sneak peeks of the next season of Men of a Certain Age?
Oh my God, I was just at Paramount about 6 days ago, and I was in the writer's room with Ray Romano and everyone, and they didn't give me any storyline. I don't even know. They'd only been writing for 4 days, so they were just getting outlines.
What kind of music do you listen to with your family?
We listen to just about anything. My parents like sort of like old classic rock, and my dad likes a little bit of country music. So usually if we're in the car together, they get to pick the radio station, so it's whatever they want.
We went to a taping of Hannah Montana on Friday, and it seemed like you guys were having a lot of fun. Any chance of a Rico Jackson spinoff?
I wish. I love that kid. I think he's so funny. I don't know what Disney has planned once the show is over, but I think that's a very good idea. Jackson and Rico, that would be gold.
if you could keep any part of the character Jackson with you at all times, what would it be?
He's just fearless. Like, it never seems like he ever gets embarrassed about anything, and I love that about him. If I could have a little bit more of that in my own life, I think that would be an amazing thing.
What kind of music do you listen to with your family and friends?
I listen to myself. I love listening to Earth, Wind, and Fire. That's a little old school, and Justin Timberlake. I listen to all types of music, but definitely positive things that we can still dance to and, you know, feel good to, but it's not saying anything uncomfortable. And that's the kind of music that I make as well.
What projects are you working on?
I just did Camp Rock 2, the final jam with Jonas Brothers and Demi Lovato, so I'm a new lead in that. And I'm working on my album with Hollywood Records.
Tell us about the character you play in the last song.
I play Liam Hemsworth's father, who played Miley Cyrus's boyfriend's father.
What kind of music do you listen to with your friends and family?
Well, we play a lot of guitar, and you know, my wife's a guitar player, and I'm a piano player, and my daughter plays both, and so we do a lot of playing and singing. We play a lot of folk songs and old country songs and stuff like that.
Tell us about the character you play in the last song.
Okay, I play Cassie, and she's the best friend of Ashley. And when Ashley's upset about Ronnie and Will hooking up, I'm there for her and comfort her and tell her that it's okay and that she can do better.
This movie is about music bringing family together. What kind of music do you listen to with your family and friends?
Oh, right now I'm really into the Avett Brothers. I love the Avett Brothers. And then classics like the Eagles and Bob Dylan and stuff like that. I really like classic rock, slow rock.
Are you anything like your character on I'm in the Band?
I'm actually so much like her. We both like the same kind of music, and we have the same style, and we both like to sing, and we're both crazy, and we're both friends with Logan Miller.
What kind of music do you listen to with your family?
We listen to a lot of Queen. I've grown up listening to Queen and Joan Jett and Pat Benatar because of that guy back there, my dad. So a lot of Queen, actually, a lot. I think I know every song.
What music do you listen to with your family and friends?
I mean, I listen to all kinds of music. Music is a big part of my life, not as big as acting, but it's still big. I'm a big fan of the Beatles, the Black Eyed Peas, Red Hot Chili Peppers, Lady Gaga's, you know, growing up there, Taylor Swift.
What projects are you working on?
I wish I could tell you. Actually, I can tell you one. I'm back on Wizards of Waverly Place. They brought my character back, which is fun. And I was just about to, you know, they let me talk about it like 2 minutes ago. So I'm happy I've been, you know, filming secretly and not being able to tweet where I am and stuff like that. And obviously when all my Twitter followers wanted me to come back on the show, which was great. So it was nice to know that my character was appreciated and loved and the accent was liked.
Tell us about your character in the last song.
I play Teddy, one of Marcus's friends. He's played by Nick Lachey, and we just kind of bully around, and you know, we're just the antagonists of the film. So, you know, we just go around and steal stuff and wreak havoc.
I'm speaking with the cast of I Heart Vampires. What are your names?
My name's Adam Chambers.
I'm Allie Kinzel. Sherilyn Wilson.
And Josh Nuncio.
Tell us about your characters in the show.
I play Wyatt, the vampire hunter, and I hate vampires.
I play Sam. I'm a fangirl. I came in season 2. I'm nerdy, and I am really obsessed with these books called Confessions of a High School Vampire. So I'm a really obsessed fangirl.
I play Corbin, and I am one of the two founding girls who created a website, all based on this book series, which very much so parallels Twilight. So
I play Nick, the vampire on the show, and I kind of watch over these girls, and then I kind of get myself into some trouble, and then they start to watch over me. So
tell us about your new DCOM, 16 Wishes.
16 Wishes, it was a phenomenal experience to go and film in Canada and in Vancouver, but then beyond that, it was just an amazing script, an amazing hardworking crew, very talented cast. I mean, it was definitely, I couldn't have imagined it going any better, and that's genuinely from the bottom of my heart. So I'm very excited for people to see it, to hear what people think.
Tell us about Harriet the Spy.
Well, Harriet the Spy, I mean, Louise Fitzhugh made such a classic book in the 1960s. And we're just trying to make sure that doesn't get lost in time. We want to make sure we bring it to the modern day kid with blogging and just different things that kids these days can relate to. So we're just trying to make sure it sticks around because it's a classic story. It needs to.
Are you at all like Harriet?
It's surprising. I'm more like Harriet than any other character I've ever played. My challenge was that I had to find characteristics that weren't like me to put to Harriet so that it wasn't just me saying a bunch of words.
How are you?
I always come over here for you. You're the best.
I'm speaking with Miley Cyrus.
Yes.
tell, what is your favorite thing about filming the last song?
My favorite thing, I think, is being able to be in Georgia. The South is like my hometown, so I love being back in the South and feeling like I'm at home.